Hi everyone, I'm Roy. Today, I'll walk you through the first two of five essential formulas for AC motors, focusing on motor speed calculations. When we talk about motor speed, there are two key speeds in AC motors: synchronous speed, often called NS, and rotor speed, often called NR. What is synchronous speed? Synchronous speed is the speed at which the magnetic field created by the stator of an AC motor rotates. It represents how many times the magnetic field rotates per minute. The formula for calculating synchronous speed in an AC motor is: synchronous speed equals 60 times the supply frequency divided by the number of pole pairs. In this formula, synchronous speed is measured in revolutions per minute. Frequency is the frequency of the electrical supply, measured in hertz. Pole pairs refer to the number of pole pairs in the motor. What is rotor speed? Rotor speed, often called NR, refers to how fast the actual motor shaft, the rotor, is spinning. In synchronous motors, the rotor locks onto the rotating magnetic field and spins exactly at the synchronous speed. In induction motors, also called asynchronous motors, the rotor always spins slightly slower than the synchronous speed, which is why they are referred to as asynchronous. The difference in speed between the synchronous speed and rotor speed is called slip. Slip formula. Slip, measured as a percentage, is calculated using this formula. Slip percent equals the quantity synchronous speed minus rotor speed, divided by synchronous speed, multiplied by 100. Recap. Synchronous speed, NS, the rotational speed of the stator's magnetic field, determined entirely by the supply frequency and the motor design, number of poles. Rotor speed, N, are the actual speed of the rotor. It matches the synchronous speed in synchronous motors but is slightly lower in induction motors due to slip. Slip speed, the difference in speed between the synchronous speed and rotor speed. Let's take a quick look at the example calculations on the screen. They show how the synchronous speed changes with different total poles, and thus different pole pairs, and walk you through using the formula NS equals 60 times F, divided by P. In one table, you see how plugging in various values for P gives you different speeds at 50 Hz. I won't go into the details here, just read the screen to see exactly how the calculations are done step by step. You can pause the screen and verify the result yourself. In the other examples, the formula is rearranged so you can solve for the number of pole pairs if you already know the target speed. You can pause the screen and verify the result yourself. Here is another example to find the supply frequency. You can pause the screen and verify the result yourself. Enjoy! In this section, we'll learn how to calculate the slip speed, slip percentage, and rotor speed in an AC motor. Calculating the slip percentage and slip speed is straightforward. Simply substitute the values for NS and NR into the formula, and you'll get the answer. Feel free to pause the screen and verify the example result yourself. Now, let's talk about how to calculate the rotor speed, NR, when you're given the synchronous speed, NS, and the slip percentage. This is a bit more challenging because you can't directly solve it using the slip formula. Here's a tip to make it easier. Since the rotor speed is slightly slower than the synchronous speed by the slip percentage, we can rewrite the formula as: rotor speed equals synchronous speed times slip percentage. By practicing these calculations with examples, you'll better understand motor speed relationships and performance. Feel free to pause the screen and verify the example result yourself. I hope you now know how to calculate motor speed. See you in the next video.